As I was listening to those final words of "You Raised Me Up," the song is about being carried by someone. But I also thought, as family, Audrey has raised you to be the people that you are. And her life is lived on in you. And her example goes before you. We gather today that we might make our final farewell to Audrey, mother, grandmother, Nan, sister of those who are not able to be here, a woman who was remarkable in many ways, a strong woman, although a small woman, a woman who was involved in many organisations, who gave of herself in many, many different ways. A woman of strong faith and commitment. A woman who has left for us a legacy of a life well lived, lived to the full. But she's not here. She has gone through death into life. She has received the promise of eternal life, and her faith was strong. You will come here, I'm sure, from time to time. You will come and you will be here and remember her, and you will give thanks for her life and her contribution and her gift to you. But the body that we bury is simply the shell of who she was. It's that which we could see and relate to. But she has now left that body. It has completed its task, and we will commit it to the ground. So let us listen to the scriptures. For God gives us some sure and certain promises. In Romans chapter 8, God says, "I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of Christ, our Lord. And Jesus himself said, I am the resurrection and the life. And those who believe in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. To love someone is to risk the pain of separation. Not to love is not to live. And so the grief that we experience is an honouring of the love that we have shared. And so as we come to this moment of farewell, part of our grief may be regret for things done or left undone, words said or never said, or moments that we wished had happened. This is a time to put all that aside, for it doesn't count anymore. Let us, in a moment of silence, make our own personal farewells, and then we shall make a committal. Now commit her body to the ground. Now that the earthly life of Audrey Melvina Bramich has come to an end, we commit her body to be buried, confident of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. To God be the glory forever. In the book of Revelation, we read that they shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. For the Lamb, which is another name for Jesus, in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd. So let us pray. Almighty God, the Father of all mercies and the giver of all comfort, we pray for those who mourn, that casting their care upon you, they may know the comfort of your love. Eternal Father, be our refuge and our strength in sorrow. As your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us conquered death, and by rising again restored us to life, enable us to go forward in faith to meet him, that when our life on earth is ended, we may be united with all who love him in your heavenly kingdom, where every tear will be wiped away. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Because of the promises of Christ, we can be assured that Audrey is reunited with those who have gone before her. And what joy that reunion brings. So a blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. I invite you to put flowers